So in this class we'll be talking about the water jet machining. We'll be talking about the schematic diagram, equipments which are used, advantages and applications. Let's move ahead. So water jet machining. So you know, water has a lot of energy in it. Fine, if you want to feel the water strength, you can just try to go to the swimming pool and fall straight, flat. Fine. So you'll see that you'll face a lot of impact. It's almost as if you're falling on flat earth. Okay? So that's how dense water is. And this dense water, if we are making it into a small thin stream, if you are able to move it in a small thin stream at a very high velocity, it has a lot of momentum. And this high momentum is enough to cause material removal also. Okay, so that's where the material, that's where the water jet machining will be of use to us. So it's a mechanical energy based non-traditional machining process. So the energy domain of this is mechanical, because it will be using shear stress for the removal of the material. Okay, then machine soft and non-metallic materials. So mostly it is used for machining soft metals. It cannot machine the brittle metals. Wherever brittle materials are there, we should go for abrasive jet machining. Wherever soft metals are there, ductile and malleable, for such metals or non-metals, we can use water jet machining. Okay? Then it involves use of high velocity water jet to smoothly cut the soft workpiece. It is similar, very very similar to abrasive jet, but we are not using abrasives here. We are using just pure water. Then in water jet machining, high velocity water jet is allowed to strike a given workpiece. During this process, kinetic energy is converted to pressure. So for converting this, what do we require? A nozzle. A nozzle converts pressure energy into kinetic energy. Fine. And also it allows the water to come in the form of very thin stream. Okay. So the thinner the stream, the more the pressure created, and more the pressure, the more easily the material gets removed. Clear? So when this induced stress is high enough, unwanted particles get removed. Fine. So that's normal. You have studied this in mechanics of materials. Fine. So pressure is applied from outside, stress is generated inside. If the stress that the workpiece can generate is less than the pressure applied, then there is deformation, failure. Fine. And that's what you see in the famous dialogue of Three Idiots also, right? If the pressure is too high, the student fails, right? So that's what happens. If the student is unable to take the stress, that's where the failure will occur, right? So you should develop yourself in such a way that you can take more stress. Anyway, coming back to our subject, this is the schematic diagram. So first we have a reservoir. What is a reservoir? That's where the water is stored. So from this water, we'll be taking that water and pumping it. And after pump, we have something called intensifier. What is an intensifier? The name itself is telling us. Intense means intensity. Intense means highly dense. So what is it doing? It is compressing it further. Fine. So there is a pump or compressor rather. So there is a pump, for water we use the term pump itself. So the pump will increase the pressure of water to some level. So that high pressure needs to be further increased. Fine. Because if you just take a small velocity jet, it will not be sufficient to remove the metal. Okay. So we have to increase it many folds. Almost 10 times of what a normal pump can provide. So for that, we use an apparatus called intensifier. We'll talk about it slightly later. So reservoir, pump, intensifier, then this is where the high pressure water gets collected. Pressurized wet water gets collected in the accumulator, and then through a control valve and a flow regulator, it is allowed to flow into nozzle. Fine. So all the piping that we are using here, that has to be metallic. Fine. Because unlike gaseous pressure, the pressure of liquid will be very, very high. You need to maintain very high pressures. Fine. So if you use normal plastic piping or some other piping which deforms easily, there are chances of leakage, bursting. Fine. So you have to be very careful when you are using any of these components. Fine. Now from the nozzle, when it flows, the pressure energy is converted to kinetic, and when it hits the workpiece, machining will take place. Fine. So there are some parameters given here. So water pressure is of the order of 4000 bars. What is the atmospheric pressure? What is the atmospheric pressure? 1.013 bars. Actually it's Pascal. 101.3 kilopascals. Fine. And that is equivalent to 1 point something bar. Almost 1 bar. Okay. So 1 bar is the atmospheric pressure, and you are increasing the pressure to 4000 bars. Fine. So very, very high pressure. And the velocity that we are getting here is 1000 meters per second. Fine. Very high velocity of water. The orifice diameter of the nozzle will vary from 0.1 to 0.3 millimeters. That means in a millimeter make 10 divisions. That is 0.1 millimeter. Okay. So 0.1 to 0.3 millimeter, that's how small the nozzle size will be. So that high pressure, this small diameter, that can generate a lot of pressure on the workpiece. Fine. And that pressure will be sufficient to cause material removal. Coming to the equipment, let us see what they are. We have already seen the diagram. Reservoir is where it supplies the water, it stores the water. Then pump is used for pressurizing water using a single plunger. Intensifier, this is a specialized equipment. What it does is it takes low pressure liquid as the working fluid, and it will compress water to very high pressure. Fine. It is very, very similar to the lever. You have seen the lever? What is the lever? One side is large, one side is small, right? So lever. Okay, so this straight line is called a lever. If you have a stone or something here, and if you apply small pressure here, small force if you apply here, very large force will be generated here.
Correct.
So this is a lever. So similar mechanism is used by the intensifier.
Fine.
So if you see the this is the intensifier here. Okay. So here. Okay. So here what you can see, this side, the area is very high.
Fine.
So low pressure liquid, if you are putting inside from this side, so that low pressure liquid will result in very high pressure liquid.
Fine.
Because high amount of area with low pressure will give us a very high force. Correct? The force will be very high, because even though the pressure is very less, the area is very, very high.
Area is very, very high.
So that will give us a lot of force. And this high amount of force, when we are dividing it with a small area, so this side you can see this area is very, very small. This area is very, very small. So this large amount of force divided by small area will give us very, very high pressure. Very, very
high pressure. Fine.
So that pressure ratio will be equivalent of the area, the ratio of the areas. Okay. So the larger area divided by smaller area, larger area divided by smaller area, that's how many times the pressure gets multiplied. That's how many times the pressure gets multiplied. Fine. So this is a rough sketch of the intensifier. Okay. So coming back after intensifier, so you can see here the output pressure, how much it is? 1500 megapascals. Then accumulator, this is where temporarily the pressurized water is stored. And tubing, when it comes to tubing, we have to use stainless steel solid tubes.
Fine. So if the wires are made up of stainless steel, how will you bend them? Bending gauges are provided. So if you are always bending it, then again there will be problem with accuracy. How far you are going to able, you'll be able to move it and all. Fine. So there are specialized types of joints provided. Okay. Some of the joints you must have seen in the table lamp. The table lamp, we can change the direction of that very easily. So that's made up of a metal. Fine. So similar to that, the metal will be used. Fine. So it's almost a mechanism which is completely leak proof. Fine. And you'll be able to move it perfectly. So understood all the equipment? So this is how the intensifier looks. Coming to the other equipments, we have tube fittings. What is a tube fitting? So metal to metal direct line contact is achieved by drawing a cone into a rounded socket. Fine. So this is what I was talking about. In your lamp, this is how the metallic rings will be there. Each ring fix into the next ring in such a way that there is a relative motion possible between those rings. And when these rings are continuously connected one after the other, it is possible to move it just like a snake. Fine. Like a snake, you can just bend it into any shape. Then coming to the walls. So what are walls? Walls always control the pressure. They regulate the pressure. The flow of fluid is controlled by walls. Okay. So you can control the direction of pressure of the pressurized water. So needle type walls are used. What is a needle type valve? So there will be an outer casing like this, and inside we will have a needle. Okay. Inside we will have this needle. So what happens by moving this needle in and out, we can control what is the area available for flow. Fine. So as the area decreases, velocity will increase. And as the area increases, velocity will decrease. Fine. But the discharge will almost remain the same. So that's the type of valve we are using. Then coming to nozzle. Nozzle effectively converts. So this outer casing that we have here, that is called as a nozzle. Fine. So the inner lining of this nozzle, that has to be very, very strong. Fine. Because water will be flowing across it with high velocity. That has to be strong and hard. So a hard material must avoid the wear under high velocity. Then sintered diamond. These are some of the materials used. Fine. Sintered diamond. Sapphire. Sapphire is also a kind of glass. So nowadays some of your mobile phones are coming with sapphire glass. Fine. Sapphire glass is very, very hard. But again, as the hardness increases, the bad thing is, the negative impact is brittleness. Fine. That is one of the main reasons why most of the companies avoid using sapphire on the mobiles. Fine. But some companies have gone ahead and used it because they must have made it strong enough. At the same time, it is very, very resistant to scratch. No matter what you put in your pockets, whether it is, keys, pen, so these things, they'll rub your mobile, right? And no matter how hard the substance you put in your pocket, the mobile screen remains scratch proof. That is the advantage of sapphires. But anyway, then tungsten carbide is another very, very hard material. So these are the materials used for making the nozzles. Next, the process details. So first, the water is mixed with something called polymer. Why polymer? Have you ever played with water bathroom? So when you there is this tube, theek hai, to nal rehta, so nal mein se chota sa barik sa pani nikalne dena, theek hai. So starting mein it will be very, very smooth, but as it comes below, it becomes turgid, hai ki nahi? So after some distance, it becomes turgid like this. Fine. So why is it becoming like that? Yeah. Resistance. You studied fluid mechanics. Height variation. Why exactly height variation? There is something called Reynolds number. Okay. Laminar flow and turbulent flow. So it depends on the velocity. Fine. And you all know gravity. So under the effect of gravity, there is acceleration. So at this point, the velocity is very low, but as it falls freely under the effect of gravity, its velocity increases. So as soon as its velocity increases beyond the limit of turbulence, it becomes turbulent flow. So that is the main reason. And this turbulent type of stream is very, very bad. It will not provide us with a lot of accuracy. Fine. Surface finish will be bad. And a lot of other problems will come up. So we want smooth, soft, laminar flow. So pure water will not provide us with that. So that's the reason we have to mix it with the polymer. So this polymer will ensure that the flow remains laminar for even greater standoff distance. We'll see that later. So next, so this is of course pressurized by intensifier. Then after this, from the accumulator, what happens? From the accumulator, so this is stored in the hydraulic accumulator. From the accumulator, it flows into the nozzle through a control valve. The control valve will regulate the pressure and how fast it is flowing, of course. Then the nozzle converts pressure energy to high speed jet. And this high speed jet, when it falls on the workpiece, it will result in machining. Then used fluid and chip particles, they get collected in the drain and which may be recycled. So the drain that we usually use, it will be shaped like this. So all the particles that we have, they will flow down, and all these metal particles, they will get collected here. Whereas at the top, there will be pure water. So from the top, we will be taking the water and pumping it further. So all the materials that are getting removed, the chips and all the other impurities, they get collected here at the bottom. So next, advantages. So it's a relatively very fast process. Abrasive jet machining, because we are using air, the pressure has a limit and there are always flaring problems and others. So material removal rate is less. Whereas here, water has a lot of density and it can remove the metal a lot faster. Then there are no heat affected zones. Water, you know, water is already a coolant. Water itself is the best coolant that you can think of. So there are no heat affected zones. Then it automatically cleans the surface of the workpiece. Then it has excellent precision because water doesn't flare. Liquid doesn't expand. What is almost incompressible? What is almost incompressible? Of course, it can be compressed, but very, very high pressure is required for compressing water. So no flaring results in very good control over the tolerance. So the tolerance is of the order of 0.005 inches. What is this? Inches. So you just convert it into millimeters. So this much tolerance can be obtained, and it's very eco-friendly and doesn't produce any hazardous gas. Abrasive jet machining, we had seen there are suspended abrasive particles, very hazardous. Whereas here we are using pure water. But this pure water, again, we should not directly leave it into the flowing streams, because we are mixing it with something. What we are mixing it with? Polymer. Not pH value. pH ke liye nahi use karte polymer. We are increasing its viscosity slightly. Because zyada viscosity badhane se kya hota hai? The flow doesn't become turbulent. It remains laminar for longer, higher velocities also. That is the reason we are mixing the polymer. So this polymer is mixed with it. And that's one of the pollutants actually. So this should not be directly left into the river. Even if you want to leave this water to the river, you have to first filter it. Purify it, and then you can leave it. But comparatively, water is much safer compared to the other approaches that we are using. So it approaches an ideal single point tool. So the effect that you are getting as a result of this, that is very similar to the single point tool. There are some more advantages. It gives clean and sharp cuts. Gases are flaring. Glasses usually they flare, and we cannot obtain very sharp edges. Whereas here, comparatively, a lot more sharper edges can be obtained. So it is best suited for explosive environment, especially where the material, the workpiece, if it is explosive, then water is the best thing to cut it with. Fine. Then it's used for cutting asbestos, glass fiber, insulation without producing dust. So these materials, the asbestos and glass fibers, they produce a lot of dust. Fine. And also they are, you know, shaped in different things, different shapes. Like if you see the packaging cartoons, if you have seen, it will be multi-layered, right? There will be an inside wavy layer, and the top and bottom will be flat. So these cartons, if you are cutting it with your mechanical equipment, that wavy part will get damaged. And the shape will get damaged, there will be compression, and there will be a lot of other things which will not only make it bad to look at, but also its strength will get compromised. So there also you can use water jet cutting to get much better cuts. Then it has very low maintenance. It has very low maintenance, and there are no moving parts in it. Fine. Intensifier, of course, it has some moving parts, but once it gets collected in the accumulator, after that there are not many moving parts in it, so maintenance is very less. Then the fluid can be reused after filtering out the solids. Solid chips, whatever formed, we can separate them. They will naturally settle down. Okay. And we can reuse it, reuse the water. Then low fluid requirement. Fine. Fluid requirement is not very high, because we are using very, very thin stream of jet. You have seen the diameter of the nozzle. What was the diameter of the nozzle? 0.1 to 0.3 mm. It's a very, very small diameter. So not much, not very high amount of water is required for this. And yeah. Then coming to disadvantages, only soft materials can be machined. We cannot machine very brittle or very hard type of materials. Then very thick materials cannot be easily machined. Thin materials can be machined. We can usually use it for cutting operations. Then initial investment is high, because leakage proof piping and intensifiers we have to use. Okay. So initial cost will be slightly higher. And I think one more disadvantage we can include here. Inside edges are not sharp enough, because water just flows. Fine. Water flows, and the flow is laminar. So inside edges, if you want very, very sharp, you cannot obtain it. Inside edges will be usually smooth. Okay. Coming to applications, it's used for cutting thin non-metallic sheets like rubber, wood, ceramics, and many other soft materials. Used for machining circuit boards, textile, leather. Fine. Used for food industry, for frozen meat. Frozen meat becomes brittle. Fine. That can be cut with a water jet. Then paint removal and cleaning can also be done using this. Mass immunization and surgery. किसमें? नहीं नहीं उसमें वो mix नहीं करते. Of course, wherever food is the case, you should avoid using all the other chemicals, right? Or else it will be contamination. Some other thing, if it is edible, that kind of oils they will try to mix with it. Vegetable oils, they generally don't mix with it well, because oil and water are enemies. Okay. So some other kind of oils which mix well with the water and increase its velocity, or oils directly can be used. High density oils can be used for cutting. Okay. There are always options. We'll have to check out the different options and choose the best which is available. Okay. Then mass immunization and surgery, peening, rocket, pocket milling, drilling, turning, these are some of the operations we can perform. And nuclear plant dismantling. Peen, you have seen the peen hammer? Backside of the hammer will have a claw shaped extension. That is called a peen. You have cross peen and straight peen, right? So peening means something like a drilling hole itself. By hitting, if you want to drill the hole, that's where it can be used. Then pocket milling, you are drilling and turning, you all know about that. Then concrete, nuclear power plant. You know what nuclear power plant is? Fine. So nuclear power plant uses a very, very thick concrete wall to avoid the radiation from flowing out. Okay. And when these nuclear power plants, they need to be dismantled. Fine. Water is the best option. Fine. Because any amount of heat generation can be dangerous. Okay. So you don't want any kind of heat to generate. So for dismantling that, we can use water jet machining. Then water jet machining materials. So which materials we can use for that? So here on the x-axis, what is there? On the x-axis, we have nozzle exit pressure in kilonewton per centimeter square. Fine. And for all the materials, almost all the materials, the graph has been given. So unsulfurized rubber, it is giving maximum depth. On the y-axis, what do we have? On the y-axis, we have depth of the groove cut. So because this is the softest rubber that we can get, the maximum groove cut we can get here. So as we go down, we are getting harder and more brittle objects. Fine. So lead is usually very soft, and the lead. So this graph is for lead. It is the longest graph you can see. Then we have here aluminium alloy, and we have this glass, fiber reinforced glass. Okay. And here we have this mild steel. We cannot do cast steel. Cast steel will be very, very brittle, very hard. Fine. So cast steel we cannot do it at all. Mild steel is possible. Brass, you have it here. Aluminium alloys, they have lesser strength. Okay. Pure aluminium, you can see it's a little harder. It has more strength, so it is giving lesser groove compared to the aluminium alloys. And you can study all these materials, and this will be helpful for you. So that finishes the water jet machining. Next class we'll probably go for abrasive water jet machining. Fine. So any doubts?